So, do you want to know how to make 2D intro animations in Sony Vegas? Well, of course you do. That's why you clicked this video. All right, so the first things you're going to need for this is you're going to need Sony Vegas 14 or 15. If you don't have 14 or 15, then I'm sure there's an easy way to like upgrade to 14 or 15 or just get it for free. I'm not going to get into that because I don't want to get arrested for doing legal things on my YouTube channel. So go ahead and look up a tutorial on how to get it for free if you don't have it, because I'm pretty sure most of these templates, which I'm going to show you guys how to get templates, are pretty much going to tell you how to use them in version 14, 15. So you're also going to need a template. I have a link to some templates in the description, so you guys can go ahead and check out some templates you want, or you can look up some for yourself. So you could start by going on Google and typing in Sony Vegas 2D intro templates if you want, or you could do the same thing on YouTube and find a video about it. All right, and go ahead and find an intro template that you want. It doesn't really matter, honestly. So I'm going to show you exactly some things that you can do with an intro template. Go ahead and find one, download for free, and make sure you download a free one because you obviously want it to be free. And now that we're on Sony Vegas, I'm gonna go ahead and open up the everything that we need to have open up the actual template that you just got, or maybe you already had the template. I don't know, you're just trying to look for a way to edit it. Okay, so I already have an intro that I've already made, but I'm going to use it as a demonstration. So here it is. Actually, I'm going to open it right up into Vegas Pro 15, and here it is. Here's the final result. Now, when you have the template open on your Sony Vegas Pro, it'll look different than this, and it'll probably have a few elements that require you to edit them, such as the text element, which is basically the intro part where, you know, it just pops up with your name. You don't want to leave that as nothing, or else it's just going to be, you know, no text, and then you're going to be very sad with your life having a very crappy intro. So make sure you go ahead and edit that, and there might be a few elements. Basically, I'm pretty sure depending on whoever made the template that you have, it will tell you what you need to edit. Don't try to edit the actual animation, like don't try to edit the actual thing going on here, because you might mess everything up. The only reason why I actually have my own thing going on there in the background is because I actually made this intro on my own, but you might not be able to do that with a template, so just don't do it unless you know what you're doing. And then yeah, so it's pretty simple after that. Now, here's a little thing that you want to have. You want to make your intro a little bit unique, because you can't just have, I mean, you could, but like, you could have it, but like, it's better to have kind of unique effects into your intro so you don't just have a plain out template intro, and some people might actually recognize it to be a template, which is not going to be good. It just doesn't look professional. So I'm going to show you a free and simple way to make very high quality kind of effects to your intro to make it kind of like custom to yourself. Now, I'm going to have a link in the description down to a group of effects that I have, and you could download for free. It's going to be on Google Docs or Google Drive. You guys can go ahead and download it, and in there it's going to be a tutorial on how to actually install the effects. And what's in there is it's like a bunch of Rice Gum, Logan Paul style, like glitch effects, like glitch transition effects and stuff. It's really professional looking effects. Once you have that downloaded and installed into your Sony Vegas, you're gonna need to do exactly what I'm gonna show you right now. So basically go to the intro once you have it rendered off. Once you have the actual template rendered off, let's pretend like this is the template and I'm finished editing it, right? Just go ahead and render it off. And then once you're done with that, take the rendered copy and then just drag it into here so it's like this. So we just have one clip, like not the edited version, but the actual rendered clip. Now we're gonna actually spice things up here. We're gonna make the text all unique, and we're gonna make a unique transition right here. So stop right before where the actual thing ends, as you could see, right before the text starts, and press S. Now you're going to have two clips, and once you have the effects downloaded and installed that I've showed you to download, go into your effects option, and you should have new and improved effects going on here. Click that, filter packages, that's where the new effects will be once you've downloaded them, and you'll have all these effects. Now, you'll see that it comes in A's and B's, and the reason it comes with A's and B's is because they have to work with two clips. The first clip is clip A, second is clip B. They have to be in two clips in order for the transition effect to work. So make sure if you're going to have one effect, do both A and B. Just, yeah, you get it. Currently, I'm on the first clip, so let's say I want to do, let's see, I'm going to do this one, pitch A. I'm going to add that one, add that, press OK. Now, very important, you have to do something that's very important. So all this is where the effect is. You're gonna have to move all this to the end of the clip in order for it to sync up with part B, because that's how the effect is gonna work with part B, synchronized and stuff. Now, this is a little bit dodgy, as I've noticed. You could press shift and select all of them, but sometimes I've noticed that doesn't work. I don't know why, but sometimes it doesn't work. But if it doesn't, try control. And also make sure you move down these points as well here to where they were, because it's very important that these points are matched up too. So just select these the best you can. And if you, okay, hold on, let me just make sure it is definitely synced up with these. Otherwise, the effect is going to be very, very messed up, and that's not going to be fun. So make sure you just, if I could just, all right, so there you go. You have the thing, and now you're going to press out, and now the A section is done. Now go into the second clip, go into the effects again, go to the same effect. Do not go to a different effect, otherwise it's going to be like really messed up. Go to pitch B, add, and luckily you don't have to fix anything because it's automatically going to be on that side. It needs to be. So just press out, and then you're going to have a wonderful new effect. As you can see, let's press play, and look at that. I mean, it looks a little bit dodgy because I just picked a random effect. I didn't really think about it, but if you know, you could do different types of things like that, and you could actually make an intro template completely unique, and no one will ever be able to notice it's actually an intro template, which is pretty unique and amazing. So there you go. And you could do multiple clips in the intro. You could do this multiple times if you want. I recommend only one time. Once you're done with that, go ahead and render it off. But for the sake of time, I'm just going to show you one last thing that you can do to make this intro very unique in its own way. So basically, what we're going to do now is we're going to open up a new project, and we're going to pretend like we're going to start a new video project. So we're going to, I don't want to save this because, but for you, you'll probably save it if you're happy with it. Press new video track, and now hop into open file, and then go to your intro that you just rendered with the new effect. So let's say intro. I'm going to use the same file, so this isn't the actual thing. I'm just going to use this as a demonstration. And let's put another video down here to like demonstrate this is going to be your actual video. Let me see. I don't know, which one should I choose? This one? Alright, cool. Alright, this one. Put that there. Let's say this is your actual video here, and this is going to be your intro that you're going to be using, right? And right now, it's fine. I mean, there's a white background and stuff. It's okay. I mean, it's not like the best or anything, but I want to show you how to spice it up real good. All right, so go ahead and get to something called Sony Chroma Key, which will be right there. And then go ahead and press add on there. Press OK. And then you will have the option for Sony Chroma Key, and then just key it out. You can do that by going into the color option and then clicking this little tool right here. And then just going to the background of the video. This is why I showed you guys that you shouldn't get something with like a pattern in the back, because if you do, then it's not going to work with the chroma key, and this is going to give it a transparent background type of effect. So, and there's Jacksepticeye's channel. So yeah, it's all good. And look what we got here. We got video. Whoa, calm down there, me. Now we have a slick animation going on here with no background. So here you go. That's all you got to do, guys. And that's how you make a custom intro without a background, or you can choose to have a background. It really doesn't matter. And yeah, and I'll have all the links that you'll need to do to get this down below as usual. And yeah, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Goodbye. Goodbye. Goodbye.